Wow, fantastic. Happy New Year to everybody. My name, as always, Ariwa Olarewaju Ali, and this is 2018. 2017 was the boom. It was such a fantastic year. I had to move away from being a tenant to becoming my own very own landlord. I had to welcome my new daughter, Sekina. A lot of fantastic things did happen in 2017. In fact, I was able to push through and get myself a training academy now. A training academy I've been planning for like 5-10 years. I've had that imagination of what I want my office to look like. And in 2017, December, I was able to achieve it. It was such a fantastic, wonderful year for me. The year 2018 is going to be something else, something out of this world. And we hope and pray that all our plans will come to pass. Now, what do I have for you for my very first video in the year 2018? This video, we are going to be talking about 5 powerful tips for intending and existing freelancers to become successful in the year 2018. So far, so good. I've been through a lot last year. In fact, right now you can see on my screen, iowalari.com, graphicspro360.com. You know, those are all my websites, which I've actually, you know, had a lot of fantastic intentions for. But I've not really been making any money out of those websites. So I plan to make a lot of money out of those websites for this year 2018. And I'm going to be working on them seriously. So let's not waste any of our time. Let's move to our videos. Right now, we want to talk about the 5 things you need to master in 2018 to become a very successful freelancer. Now, this is going to be very comprehensive. So I want you to probably find a pen and a paper to write things down. But I'm going to be very fast as usual, because I always try to cut down my time and to make use of the most affordable time I've got. So we're going to be talking about the 5 things that you need in the year 2018 to become a very, very successful freelancer. So these are the 5 things I've come to understand from experience, from conversations with clients, from other freelancers' experience, from courses I've actually bought from other successful freelancers. And I've been able to, you know, summarize everything I've learned into these 5 very important things you need to master. Once you master these 5 important tips I'm going to be, you know, teaching you today, I'm going to be exposing to you today, you probably know some of them anyway, then you will definitely have a fantastic story to tell by the end of the year 2018. So let's move. The first thing you need to learn, the number one thing you need to learn to master, is your skill. As a freelancer, you are meant to understand the technicalities, the necessities, everything that surrounds your skill. Now, it's not just about being a graphic designer or being a writer or being a web designer. You have to be able to understand, you know, the entirety of what you want to offer as a service. You know, from experience, I've met clients that actually know what they are doing. They actually, you know, have a very good idea about what they actually want you to do for them. And if you, as you know, the service provider, don't really know much about the service, you know, I've met a lot of people that, oh, they want to learn this, they want to start making money, you know, from graphic design, because majorly everybody know me about, you know, as a graphic designer. So a lot of people do not know that I do copywriting, I do web design, I do video animation, I do so many other things online. I learned so many other things before I actually became, you know, a full-blown graphic designer online. So you see clients that want to, you know, give you a job, a graphic design job, not because they cannot actually do what they want to do, but because they don't have the time. So they expect you, you know, you showcasing yourself as a professional to be able to give them the kind of quality they want. So eventually, if you don't know how to do this very well, maybe you are just learning the ropes, and you want to outright start making a lot of money out of it while you are learning the ropes, then you are going to get yourself into trouble very soon. That's the reason why you see, you know, a lot of people on Fiverr offering services and they are getting a lot of negative reviews. You know, sometimes you do have very bad buyers, but sometimes, most of the time, when you look at the sellers themselves, they are not of top quality. They do not have the skill set to actually offer that particular service their offering. And because of that, it becomes, you know, an issue for them to be able to really, you know, make something out of what they are doing. So you need to learn your skill, you need to perfect your skill for you to actually become a successful freelancer. So you need to master your own skill. You need to be actually like 150% very good with your skill. I've had situations before where, you know, my clients give me a job to do. After designing, I will deliver to the client, and the client will actually correct the design I did and send it back to me and tell me this is how I want it to look. And then I'll start wondering, when you actually know how to do this, why are you giving the job to me? Why are you paying me up to $50, $100, $200 to do something that you can actually do yourself? So it's one of those things you come to wonder why clients actually give job to you as a freelancer, as a professional. It is not because the client cannot do this thing. It's because the client believes you are the one that is doing this thing full time. Let me give an example of something like this. It's like you know how to fix a bulb. You know how to unscrew stuff. You bought a screwdriver. Like myself, I have screwdrivers and everything in my house. I usually, you know, in fact, my laptop, I can actually dismantle it and actually put it back together again. But still yet, we take some of these things, or we have to call technicians to actually do some of these things for us. Not because we can't do it ourselves, but because we actually want the person that is a professional in that field to handle this thing, so that there won't be any issues eventually. So this is one of the reasons why you should become a master of your skill. Please, please, in the year 2018, if you have not mastered your skill, go out there and learn more about your skill set. Stop being lazy and stop trying to play tricks on your customers by trying to think you can actually just play on their intelligence. People will not be happy when you play on their intelligence, and they will not give you good reviews when you actually play on their intelligence. So it's like you being a writer, and then, you know, when you write something, you write a complete, you know, book for someone, and your buyer actually goes through what you have written, makes corrections, and sends it back to you to edit. It's not like the buyer cannot actually edit it, but the buyer is just sending it back to you to edit, because you are the professional. So you need to become a master of your skill. This is the number one priority you need to do in the year 2018. Number two, master the industry. Now, there is a trend going on which everybody that knows me or knows what I stand for on Fiverr, which is actually my key, you know, freelance site where I work, they know that I hate the idea of fake reviews. So a lot of people bring so many other things into it, emotional things, like saying, did your account start from Nigeria, where this, that. And the reason why, let me give you a very solid reason why I personally do not like the idea of, you know, fake review. Now, the reason why I do not like the idea of fake review is that it's not like fake review doesn't work for people. It's working for a lot of people, and they are making a lot of money from, you know, getting fake reviews, and they get people place order. Actually, we all know that the idea of fake review started a very long time ago, like on Amazon, on so many other sites, where the sellers on these sites will actually pay people to come and, you know, give reviews about their products and services. And eventually, when real buyers actually come in and purchase those products and services, they come to realize and discover that these products and services are not as elaborate, as exquisite, as, you know, professional as these other guys have actually reviewed them. And it becomes infuriating, and they actually blast the whole thing up. So when you learn to master your industry, mastering your industry only requires you to understand everything surrounding that particular niche in which you find yourself. Like today, as a graphic designer, I'm supposed to understand the industry. What is the standards in the industry? If I'm into logo design, I have to understand what is the standards with logo design. Not just become a logo designer and start designing logos. Well, I need to understand what does columns mean. Why do we use particular colors for particular logos? What types of logos do we have? Is it just create a logo for a client? You know, so many things you need to understand about your industry. It is when you master your industry that you can easily convince any client that comes to you talk to the client, converse with the client, and the client comes to understand that this person is a core professional. And once you are able to convince the client that you understand the industry, you're part of the industry, you know what's happening within the industry, you will be able to charge your client more money than is expected. In fact, what I'm actually sharing with you today, I've been using it for a very long time, but I actually upgraded on that level last month, December last month. I upgraded on the level and I was able to make, in fact, a whole lot of money within a very short period of time. And I plan to, continue to work towards that particular, idea which I've actually started up last year, December. And I want to see what I'll be able to achieve this year in 2018. So you need to master your industry. It is very important for you. And once you master your industry, then everything is definitely going to change for you. The number three tip I'm going to give to you today is master your platform. You need to master the platform in which you are actually working as a freelancer. If you are on Fiverr, you need to master how the Fiverr platform works. Their TOS, their terms of service, everything they want, everything they don't want. What can you do? What can you not do? How do you do things that would actually just make them give you warning? How do you do things that will actually make them just close down your account? How do you even converse with the customer care representatives of this website? And how do you actually live and succeed and thrive within this platform? You need to be able to master the platform in which you are working as a freelancer. If you are on Upwork, you need to master the platform. If you are on freelancer.com, you need to master the platform. Once you master the platform which or where you work as a freelancer, then you are definitely going to enjoy the platform and you are going to make a whole lot of money from the platform. It is a necessity for you to master the platform. I personally have mastered the Fiverr platform. I see things every day. I brainstorm ideas every day and I continually see what actually works and what does not work. And I always work towards, ensuring that I update myself and I upgrade myself to make sure that I continue to remain relevant within the platform so that I will not just fall back and then start telling stories that this was when we used to actually be successful on the platform. So you need to understand, you need to master the platform. It is the number two thing I actually teach in my Fiverr course, mastering the platform. You master the platform, you become a master of the platform, then you definitely succeed on the platform. That is the number three thing you have to master this year, 2018. Number four, master your customers. You need to be able to understand that your customers are people that you need to communicate effectively with. There's this notion that they say customer is king, right? But I've created my own notion saying the professional is king to the client. The customer is king to, the seller. A customer is different from a client. When you have customers only come, they give you a job, they go. There's no conversation, there's no communication, there's no, sharing of value. You don't add any value to their knowledge. They only come, they give you the job, they go. Why clients, when they come, they expect you to be a master of your skill, to be a master of the industry, to understand the platform. So when your clients come, you sit them down, communicate with them. It is a necessity for you as a professional to be able to bring your customers or your clients to such a level where they actually follow everything you say. Let me give you a very good example. If you go to the hospital and probably you have an headache and you go to the hospital, what will the first thing that will happen? The doctor will ask you questions, right? Okay, what's happening? What's this? What's that? You give doctors answers. You only give the doctor a clue to what is actually happening. And then the doctor starts telling you what to do and what not to do. You only listen to the doctor if and when you think the doctor is actually a real doctor, certified doctor, experienced doctor that is actually sharing with you a knowledge base that you cannot fathom. He's sharing with you his skill, his experience, his knowledge of the industry, and you are accepting everything he's telling you because you believe he is a professional. So you become a client, not a customer. But in a situation whereby you don't think the person is a professional, you can be telling the person, I can do this myself, I know how to. That is when customer is king. So you need to be able to master the system, master your game, master your skill, master the industry, master the platform for you to be able to master your customers. Once you get to that stage, you'll be able to control your customers. You'll be able to tell your customers what you want them to do, how you want them to do it, and they are going to do it. They will definitely do it for you. But once you don't understand the first three things you need to master, then your customers will become your king. Your customers will tell you, do this, do that, you are not doing this way, you are not doing that way, because you don't know what you are doing. So if you know what you are doing, you become a master of those four three things, the first three things, then you are going to be a master of your customers. It is just as simple as that. There's nothing that is more rewarding than you understanding your game, being a master of the game, and being able to control the tempo within yourself and your customers. Your customer will even beg you, oh please, I don't have this amount of money, could you please reduce the price a little bit? Not because your customer, you know, just because your customer believe you are the master of the game, because they know you can actually give them what they want. So you need to be able to do those things, you know, for you to be able to master your customers. And then another thing about mastering your customers before I leave is, when you master your customer, one of the ways you master your customer, as a graphic designer, I do this a lot of time. The customer gives me a job. We communicate, I tell him this is your price, he or she agrees, then I will make multiple amounts of that particular design. Let me say I want to do a logo design for a client. Instead of designing one logo, I can actually make two, three, or four different concepts of the client's logo. Now, that will definitely blow up the client. And the client will be like, wow, this person is so talented, he's so real, so good. In fact, whatever he says about this, I'm going to accept it. That is how you master the game. That's how you master your customers. You need to be able to do things in a variety of ways. You need to be able to convince your clients, your customers, that you are a master of your game, and then your customers will definitely do whatever you want them to do. And the final tip I'm going to give you for the year 2018, January 1st, is master your time. You need to be able to understand that everything is time. Time is money, time is life, time is this, time is, everything is time. You have to be able to master your time. Know what to use your time for, know when to learn, know when to relax, know when to play with your family, know when to go out, know when to stay indoors, know when to sleep, know when to, you need to master your time. A freelancer becomes a freelancer because he wants his freedom. Is that not why we call, that's the reason why the word free is in front of freelancer. Because we want to become free. We want freedom. How will you get freedom? You can only get freedom by mastering your skill, mastering the industry, mastering your platform, mastering your customers, and then you get your freedom. You'll be able to master your time. That is when and only when you now have clients that will be able to tell, I'm sorry, right now is 11 a.m. here, I've got to go sleep. When I wake up tomorrow morning, I'm going to finish your job. And the client will say, oh, please go and take a rest. Tomorrow, you're going to finish the job. But when you can't master your time, even your time zone, if you can't master your time zone, there's going to be a lot of things. There's going to be. Now, a lot of people still will say, when they were having, you know, issues as freelancers, that people all over the world do not want to see some particular set of countries. But I've come to realize the fact that I've seen people from Pakistan, Bangladesh, India, they don't change their IP, they don't change their location, they don't change their address, and they still become successful freelancers. I personally, when I started freelancing, I insisted I'm going to be using my Nigerian, you know, details and everything. I did that for like 9 months, like a year. It wasn't successful. I was forced to, you know, actually use some other environment. But during the process of the 2 years I was actually in the US, quote and unquote, I realized I got a lot of opportunities which I would have, you know, made use of, but I couldn't make use of them because it wasn't me. But until it became me, the opportunities blew up. Right now, I'm telling you, I can actually call any of my clients in the US. I can message any of my clients in the US. I'm coming to the US. How can we see? And we'll be able to communicate effectively. And I'll be able to arrive at the client's, you know, very house. Because my clients now know I'm from Nigeria. So sometimes you just have to be able to master everything. Your time zone, your physical time, your everything, for you to be able to succeed as a freelancer online. It is the year 2018. No matter what is going to happen this year, I want you to make sure that you take these five very important factors, write them down, paste them on the wall in your room, look at them every time, and start working towards mastering these five very important things. I'm always Ariwola Iwaju Ale, and this is the year 2018. It's gonna be such a fantastic year for all of us. Thank you so much. I love you guys. Goodbye and God bless.